And finally tonight, we meet an artist who happens to be very statuesque. You could even say that his work has an incredible lifelike quality. He happens to be one of Pete's people.
My concept is to present my work, present my art to a wide range of people in a context which they wouldn't expect it, and that's why I do what I do. Surprise!
Is he real?
It's Harold Olejarz.
I think he's real. Is it?
Statue, right? The art is active and the viewer is active and there's this interchange that occurs. And I think that's what's very exciting about my work.
That's what people are, a mask in hard. And it represents people of New York.
Especially in New York City, where statues are as common as pigeons.
Check this out. It's a bad set of stuff you got there, pal.
It's like fishing. You just sort of stand there and wait. And eventually something happens.
Oh, he's from Jersey. Newark. Well, that radioactive waste over there.
You just came from Holland?
Mine, too.
Want to take me out?
You went first.
Uh-huh. I asked you.
Oh.
Frustrated office worker.
No, he's a starving artist. When Harold's not busy driving a limo, he's changing clothes in the garage.
Rather than having to deal with bureaucracies and all kinds of institutions, I can just put on my art and bingo, have an art show.
Have you made out of metal or what is it made out of?
Rubber.
The rubber man.
That to me is the biggest excitement about my work, seeing the feedback that I get from people, how they respond to my work and how different and varied it is.
See you, man. Hey, what's going on?
He moved first, so I didn't move. I looked at him straight on, and he moved his hand, and I didn't even blink. I'm proud of myself.
And for a reporter, so am I. What art? In Central Park, 3.2, Channel 90.
There's a lot of fun with it.